The dog days of summer are here. You can hear children splashing in pools, keeping cool from the hot, sultry days. Frogs echo from the fringes of the ponds, and cicadas hum from the top of the trees. Fields of alfalfa, corn, and grasses lay a beautiful patchwork of contrasting green squares amongst the areas of forest. It is hard to imagine, while admiring such an amazing landscape of farm and forest, that early in the season there was an insect pest that hitched a ride on a thunderstorm to feed on your alfalfa. Yes, a lime green insect about 1/8 inch long has ridden on the storms from the southern and midwestern United States looking for alfalfa and other host plants. This storm rider is potato leafhopper, and it thrives during the dog days of summer. So while you're trying to keep cool, potato leafhopper is having a merry old time in your alfalfa fields. The storm-riding adult female potato leafhoppers are strong flyers and can move from plant to plant, laying 2 to 3 eggs per day. Bright yellow-green nymphs hatch from the eggs in search of plant juices. These similar-looking adult and nymphs use their needle-like mouthpart to inject into the plant and suck phloem. While the insects are sucking the plant juice, they replace it with the toxic saliva. Large infestations of potato leafhopper and alfalfa can reduce plant protein by 5% and yield by 0.5 ton per acre per cutting. If you see V-shaped yellowing on the tips of the leaves, you have a good chance potato leafhopper has been in your alfalfa. It gets even worse. If V-shaped yellowing has appeared, you already lost protein and yield, plus the alfalfa will have a slower regrowth after harvest and increased chance of winter kill. You might think it's time to throw in the towel, but we can deal with this little beast by scouting fields on a weekly basis. Scouting alfalfa fields is a key to early detection of potato leafhopper infestations. With the use of a 15-inch diameter sweep net, you can determine if a potato leafhopper infestation has the potential to cause economic loss in your alfalfa. Scouting for potato leafhopper starts after the first cutting of alfalfa, about the first part of June, until the first fall frost. You will want to use a potato leafhopper sequential sampling plan to determine if an infestation requires management or not. The first thing you need to do is to determine the height of your alfalfa. Smaller plants are more vulnerable to potato leafhopper, thus there are different action thresholds for different heights of alfalfa. The second thing you will need to know how to do is to sample for potato leafhopper. A sample is 10 sweeps of the net. A sweep is one pass across the front of you through the alfalfa. The return swing is counted as another sweep. You will count the number of potato leafhoppers in your net for each sample, which is the 10 sweeps of the net. Sequential sampling reduces the time spent in each field and tells you whether you're above or below an economic threshold. Use the following card to determine potato leafhopper infestation levels. Write down the number of potato leafhoppers for each sample taken on the card. Add each sample to the next, keeping a running total of potato leafhoppers. You will need to take at least 3 samples using the sequential sampling method. On the sequential sampling card, N is defined as no treatment or no management needed at this time, and T is defined as treatment or management needed within a week. If the sample is smaller than the N number, then stop and scout 7 days later. If the number of potato leafhoppers is larger than the T number, then management action is needed to be taken within a week. If the number of potato leafhoppers fall between N and T, then continue and take the next sample till a decision can be determined. Here is an example. You measured the alfalfa at an average of 8 inches tall. So select that category in the card. Then take your first sample or 10 sweeps of the net. You count 5 leafhoppers, write them down, and keep a running total. Do it again, and you get 7 more, and a total of 12. In the third sample, you can start comparing your count with the chart. You get 9 more leafhoppers and a total of 21. 21 falls between the 19 no treatment and the 41 treatment guidelines. That means go to the next sample. In the next sample, you get 6 more potato leafhoppers and a total of 27. When you compare this with the chart, you fall below the threshold. This means you can stop and come back within a week. When taking samples, make sure you keep your pattern random each time you scout a field. Make sure you are at least 30 feet into a field before starting your sampling. The edges of fields can have biased numbers of potato leafhoppers and may not give you a true representation of a population in a field. Now you must need to know what to do if an infestation reaches a management action level. The great part is that you have two good options for controlling an infestation of potato leafhopper in alfalfa. Harvesting early can control potato leafhoppers if the field is within a week to 10 days of a scheduled harvest. By removing the alfalfa early, you can prevent potato leafhopper from reaching infestation levels that can cause yield and quality loss to the forage. Make sure that the whole field is harvested at the same time. If a field is not clean harvested, then the alfalfa that has not been cut will serve as a refuge for potato leafhoppers and can reinfest, thus severely damaging alfalfa regrowth. Insecticide control is sometimes necessary when a field is not within a week of harvest. For selection of an insecticide, consult the current issue of Cornell Guide for Integrated Field Crop Management. Remember to read the label and be aware of the interval time the alfalfa can be harvested. A third option is to plant potato leafhopper resistant alfalfa. During years when potato leafhoppers may be at levels that cause yield losses, the resistant alfalfa will not lose yield or quality. Many cultivars now are highly resistant, thus maintaining yield and quality. A resistant cultivar also fits well into an organic system or where a field might be near housing or public areas. Many agricultural professionals have stated that all alfalfa planted should have resistance to potato leafhopper. As you enjoy the sights and sounds of summer while keeping cool, just remember that potato leafhopper may be having a party on your alfalfa. Scouting for potato leafhopper in alfalfa is the only way to know if they are there. Don't wait till it's too late, or the storm rider may get your alfalfa.